Christ is our hope and our strength. You are listening to Eastertide Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace, siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Monday, the 19th of April, 2021, third week of Easter. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that putting off our old self with all its ways, we may live as Christ did. For through the healing paschal remedies, you have conformed us to his nature, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Elizabeth M. Lubulela, a Daily Bread member from Nairobi, Kenya.
They could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he spoke. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Acts chapter 6, verse 8 to 15. In those days, Stephen, full of grace and power, did great wonders and signs amongst the people. Then some of those who belonged to the synagogue of the freedmen, as it was called, and of the Syrians, and of the Alexandrians, and of those from Sicilia and Asia, arose and disputed with Stephen. But they could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he spoke. Then they secretly instigated men who said, "We have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and God." And they stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes, and they came upon him and seized him and brought him before the council and set up false witnesses who said, "This man never ceases to speak words against the holy place of the law. For we have heard him say that this Jesus of Nazareth will destroy this place and will change the customs which Moses delivered to us." And gazing at him, all who sat in the council saw that his face was like the face of an angel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Pidewa Agbangba, a Daily Bread member and a Salesian of Don Bosco from Lomé, Togo.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John chapter 6, verse 22 to 29. After 5,000 men had eaten their fill, the disciples of Jesus saw him walking on the sea. On the next day, the people who remained on the other side of the sea saw that there had been only one boat there, and that Jesus had not entered the boat with his disciples, but that his disciples had gone away alone. However, boats from Tiberias came near the place where they ate the bread after the Lord had given thanks. So, when the people saw that Jesus was not there, nor his disciples, they themselves got into the boats and went to Capernaum, seeking Jesus. When they found him on the other side of the sea, they said to him, "Rabbi, when did you come here?" Jesus answered them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you seek me not because you saw signs, but because you ate your fill of the loaves. Do not labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to eternal life, which the Son of Man will give to you. For on him has God the Father set his seal. Then they said to him, what must we do to be doing the works of God? Jesus answered them, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he has sent. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We resume our lessons from the Gospel of John, which will carry us through until Saturday this week, which is the 24th of April. So the whole week we are dealing with chapter 6 of the Gospel of John. The people had been fed. Jesus had walked on water. This is how John opens this verse 22 of chapter 6, saying, after 5,000 men had eaten their fill, the disciples of Jesus saw him walking on the sea. The two are linked. They're walking on the sea and the feeding of the 5,000, making sure that they have their fill, making sure that they are indeed satisfied. He walks on water to tell them it was a sign upon a sign. The feeding of the thousands, which implies eradicating the cause of evil, of all evils, and the walking on water, which implies the power he has over the forces of evil, shows us a God who has power over all that perturbs us, over all that disturbs us, over all that affects our well-being. And now these people start looking for Christ. Where are they looking for him? Not in his word, not in prayer, not in the house of God. No, they go to look for him at a place where he had made the loaves. They go to that place. They can't find him there. That's a problem. We get stuck. We get stuck in one place where we found God blessing us. And we start looking for the same things that God had provided for us. We don't get them. We lose focus. These people thought Jesus was going to be there and feeding them every day, because now they were hungry. And so they went back to that place, expecting to find him there again to multiply the loaves, forgetting that it was just a sign. Jesus wasn't going to create a lazy nation, a nation that did not want to do anything, just expecting God to do things for them. He wanted to create a nation that understood what he had done was a sign, and that they should not labor for things that do not last. And with that, a discourse has begun. Is now taking an opportunity to take through these people a moment of catechesis for them to understand what that sign was all about. It was not for them to get stuck there in the theology of prosperity, the preaching of prosperity. You know, when you come to Christ, oh, no more trouble. Oh, you are going to be rich. Oh, you are going to get this. You are going to get that. That is not what he wants to preach to the people. He wants to preach to them a different spirituality. Not the spirituality of prosperity, which is not even a spirituality. Jesus is telling them, listen, what I did was not for you to make of me a source of your material benefits. What I did for you was for this to happen in your lives, to understand that I take care of your essential needs. Just believe in me, and you are going to see the work of God in your lives. So they come to him. And they don't find him where he had multiplied the loaves. So they got into the boats. They found him in Capernaum. Oh, Lord, when did you come here? You know, we have been looking for you. We have been looking for you. I understand your problem. I understand why you have been looking for me. You've been looking for me not because you saw a sign. You've been looking for me not because you saw in me as the source of life, as a source of provision, but you saw in me just as one who dishes out something to eat so that you don't have to work. But I want to tell you this. Do not work. Do not labor for food that does not last. Labor for food that leads to eternal life. That's what I want to let you understand. I want you to shift your focus from material things because they won't take you anywhere. I have seen people trying to gain material prosperity and they end in death. But if you want life, believe in me, says the Lord. Focus your attention on me. And this will be the journey we are going to tread with Christ in this week. He has to convince us that what is important is Him, not anything else that we can get from Him. The first reading of today prepares us for the martyrdom of Stephen, the first one to die for Christ. And we are told that this man was filled with power and the Holy Spirit, and he worked so many wonders among the people. His wisdom was unmatched. And even when they wanted to find a way of bringing him down, they failed. Why? Because they could not withstand the wisdom and the spirit with which he was speaking. So they tried to plot against him. They spoke against him. They said a lot of terrible things against him in order to bring him down. It happens. It happens many times with the men of God. It happens many times with men and women of God. When you are trying to do your best for God, that is when others try to look for ways of bringing you down. When they brought Stephen before the Sanhedrin, what we hear is his face was like that of an angel, not of a devil. He wasn't upset. He wasn't looking broken. No, he was glowing. He was glowing. He was a man who knew where he was going. When you know where you are going, nobody can even change your face when things are tough. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Monday to you.
Thanks be to God.